हेलो एवरीबॉडी, इज द ऑडिबिलिटी एब्सोल्युटली फाइन? प्लीज गाइस जस्ट अ मिनट, वेट फॉर वन सेकेंड. आई थिंक देर इज वन स्लाइट प्रॉब्लम इन द अदर चैनल, द ब्रॉडकास्टिंग ऑफ द अदर चैनल. जस्ट वेट फॉर वन सेकेंड प्लीज. जस्ट अ मिनट गाइस, जस्ट वन मिनट प्लीज. ओके फाइन, मीनवाइल लेट्स स्टार्ट. आई थिंक देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम एट आरबीआर सर्च चैनल, बट आई थिंक देर इज स्लाइट प्रॉब्लम एट द अदर चैनल. Right?
Okay, fine. Meanwhile, let's start.
Yeah.
I think there is no problem at RBR Search channel,
so I think let's start this, and meanwhile, we see if we can solve this problem.
Yeah.
Great. Okay, fine. So let's start. Meanwhile, I think we should start the session. And we'll see if we can able to solve this, because there is some problem with the other channel. Right. So in today's class, we will be discussing the best of permutation combination probability. This is what this entire session is all about. I hope and I believe you are really excited for the session. Not just this, prior to this, that is today in the morning on FT Express, there was one video which was there. It was a short video, and just like this, because you guys liked the video. So tomorrow there will be one more short video available. Its duration is, I guess, 24 minute, and it is a video on geometry. So you'll understand a very beautiful concept, and you will probably enjoy the topic as well, right? Till date, as I promised earlier, I'll be taking 18 sessions, 9 sessions on 9 days, 9 into 2, 2 sessions per day. So I have been taking session at 8 in the morning and 10 in the evening. Immediately after this, we'll be having another session on verbal at 10. And other than this, I have been taking some special classes as well. And I have already told you guys that each one of you, even if you don't have even the slightest of the idea of aptitude, if you watch all these videos, my target is 20, get 20, 21 students. I will bring a fresh class, a new class on YouTube, Unacademy app, special classes, special free classes, and then there are many other classes on Unacademy platform as well for 22 and 23 students. But currently, the main target, main audience is the one who are about to give their paper in the next week, right? So I hope and I believe that all of you have been watching all these videos, and you have been maintaining notes. So each one of you, please confirm that you guys have been watching all these videos and making proper notes. Shall I consider that all of you are actually have watched all the videos, and you have been making notes, like you have been writing every single point? Great, absolutely good to see that. So in any case, if you face any problem, you can always let me know. In case if you have any reservations, you can let me know. Tomorrow at 7 in the morning, this video you can see. When in doubt, take a risk. This will be available on FT Express. So tomorrow you will see my two videos on FT Express. First this one, and one small video on geometry. when the today's video was broadcasted, I saw some of the comments. A few of the South Indian students said, sir, because it is in Hindi, I cannot able to decipher. So I've made sure that tomorrow's video, the one which will going to broadcast on FT Express, I have made it bilingual. I have repeated every single statement twice, one in Hindi and one in English. So it will be so that each and every one of you can understand, so that the linguistics won't be any bar. Fine. So I saw that in the comment, that was a few of the students said this comment. So I've made sure, like, I do this tomorrow. Once again, we're going to meet at 10 in the evening, and tomorrow we're going to meet once again for our sixth session. Right. So that will be really good. Other than this, these are my credentials. You can pause the video and you can see this. I have been teaching to the students for the past 10 years. Mainly, I have been teaching to the CAT students, CAT aspirants. Other than that, GATE aspirants, bank, SSC, different students for the past 10 years. You know what you can do? You can install the Unacademy app. I have already brought like many free classes on YouTube, and this is my promise to you guys. I will going to bring in the month of February itself, I'll be bringing many more classes and courses, free and paid both. Let me be very, very clear with this. Free and paid both. Free classes and free courses will be there, and paid classes and paid courses will also be there, right? So that is the thing. So like, for example, the paid courses will be like Plus and Iconic subscription. In case of Plus, there'll be live classes, weekly tests, and you know, the best part is linguistics won't be any bar. I personally prefer Iconic because it has got one-to-one mentorship. But in addition to that, as I told you, I will be bringing free classes and free courses on Plus subscription as well. So what you can do, you can install the Unacademy app meanwhile. For example, for the paid courses, whether it is Plus or Iconic, you can use ST26, ST Saurabh Thakur, 26 is my date of birth, to avail the maximum benefit that will really help you. This is the idea which I like the most, just telling you my opinion. For example, if you are enrolled for 12 months, in this particular vertical, in GATE vertical, GATE EAC vertical, you have the authority to watch whosoever teacher is there. You have the choice to watch any video whichever you want. That is the best part. This I believe is the best part. In case of Iconic subscription as well, you can, if you want, you can avail the benefit by using the code ST26, ST Saurabh Thakur 26. Sir, you said you will be bringing free courses, free classes, free courses, as well as paid courses on Unacademy platform, right? Sir, how am I supposed to know that when you have brought this? So what you can do, you can install the Unacademy app and you can follow Saurabh123Thakur251618. This you can follow, and whatever classes I'll be bringing or whatever course I'll be bringing, you'll get the notification, right? The classes which we have been taking for the past few days and today itself, you'll get the notes, you'll get the questions, especially the PDFs on FT Express, and other than this, Saurabh Sir Official, both the channels, right? So this is the thing. And you can always like, subscribe, and especially comment. I personally read every single comment whichever you post, right? So you can always let me know whatever you feel, but there should be some morality, like there should be some minimum base, like there should be some benchmark whenever we comment, but it's up to you guys. In case of any reservations, any doubt, you can let me know. Today's session is about permutation, combination and probability, the very best of this. And I'll be taking the series, the best of permutation, combination, probability, the best of time, split distance, work and time, Nimbra system, all these topics I'll be taking. Shall we start today's session? Is everybody absolutely ready? Is absolutely ready? Great. Fine. So I think we should start today's session. Even before starting today's session, I want people to write in the comment box, I live to express, not to impress. Whatever your inevitable reality is right now, wherever you are in your life right now, I'm saying this to you, can we make this philosophy that from today and onwards, I will never become prisoner of someone else's opinion. Someone's opinion of me should never become my destiny. I will never leave to impress, but rather I leave to express. That is more important. Such that 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years down the line, when we look back to our life, we should be in this position to say that I fought a good fight and I'm proud of myself. When we leave this planet, when we go to heaven, hell, wherever, then let's give a chance to God such that the God can ask us, how was the heaven? We are our choices. Make sure you don't join the easy crowd. Let's start today's session. Permutation, combination, probability. Let's start. Let us suppose we have 8 official members and 4 non-official members. Let us suppose we have 8 official members and 4 non-official members. Let us suppose we have 8 official members and 4 non-official members. Okay. So, and if we have been told that we have to select 5 to form a committee or to form a team. Listen to this. After 120 minutes, you will feel extremely confident about whatever we could able to discuss. The idea is not to discuss as many questions as possible. The idea is to discuss like whatever number of questions we can able to discuss. The idea is that should the concept should be absolutely clear to each and every one of you, right? Let us suppose we want to form a team comprised of 5 people. So if we have 8 official members and 4 non-official members, and if we want to form a team, a committee which has got 5 members, so that can be done in 8 plus 4, that is all in all we've got 12 members. So 12C5. What is the meaning of 12C5? 12C5 means this. There are 12 people, and out of 12 people, we want to select 5. That is what it means. Out of 12 people, we want to select 5. Great. Sir, do we need to what? No, sir, I was thinking of what? Actually, I was thinking of arrangement. Why arrangement is required? Let us suppose that you guys are standing over here, 12 people are standing over here, and I want to select 5. Let us suppose I have selected A, B, C, D, E. I have selected A at the first place, B at the second place. Instead of this, if I select B at the first place and A at the second place, what will happen? There won't be any arrangement when you are selecting 5 guys. If we want these 5 guys to sit at 5 different places, now the arrangement will take care of itself. Now the arrangement has to come. 12C5 into 5 factorial. But for that to happen, you need to make sure that these 5 people must sit at 5 places. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? Right? Is it fine to each and every one of you? Right. Great. Absolutely fine. So what is that? That is 12C5. Now listen to this very, very carefully. Let us suppose if we have been told that we have to select 3 official. This is the first question. And 2 non-official. We have to select 3 official and 2 non-official individuals. We've got 8 official and 4 non-official individuals. If there is no condition, we can directly say 12C5. But if we have been told that we have to select 3 official and 2 non-official, the very first thing I want you people to write this absolutely clearly and categorically, that when nothing is mentioned, it does not mean at least, at most, it only mean exactly. When nothing is mentioned, when only this part is written that you have to select 3 official members and 2 non-official members, what exactly it means? It means you have to select exactly 3 official members and you have to select exactly 2 non-official members. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, guys? Sir, you mean to say that because we've got 8 official members, so we can clearly write it as 8C3 and 4C2. Forget about the values, you'll find it, you can find it later on. That's not the point. The idea of this session is to discuss on the concept. We can find the values, right? So after the class, you can find these values. Is it clear? Is the very first point clear to each and every one of you? When nothing is mentioned, when there is absolutely no condition, we have written 8 plus 4, that is 8 plus 4 is 12C5. Great. In case if we have been told that we have to find 3 official and 2 non-official members, the very first thing, the very first important point is, when nothing is written, it means we are talking about exactly 3 official and exactly 2 non-official members. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Mohit Sarvade, is it clear? So 3 official and 2 non-official members. So 3 and 2. So 3 official members. How many members do we have? How many official members do we have? We have got 8 official members, and out of 8 we have selected 3. We have got 4 non-official members, and out of that we've selected 2. I think this is absolutely clear, right? Great. Right? Let's move on to the next one. Let us suppose we have been told that we've got actually 8 official members and 4 non-official members. And let us suppose we have been told that, the second part of the question. Let us suppose we have been told that we have to select. What is that we have to select? We have to select at least 2 official members. We have to select at least 2 official members. The very first thing in this case, official members must be greater than or equals to 2. This is the important part. When we have been told that we have to select at least 2 official members, it means that official members can be 2 or more than that. How many official members do we have? 8. So 8C2 or 8C3 or 8C4 or 8C5. First of all, this is the meaning at the very first place. When you say at least 2 official members, so at least 2, more than 2, 3, 4 and 5. But the constraint is, we want to form a team, and that team must have 5 members. So because we are running short of 3 more members, and that is why we have to select 3 more over here. So from non-official, we have to select 3. From non-official, we have to select 2. From non-official, we have to select 1. From non-official, we cannot select any. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, guys? We can find the value later on, right? That is not the part. That is not that important. Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear? Great. Fine. So the point is, 8C2 into 4C3, 8C3 into 4C2, 8C4 into 4C1, 8C5 into 4C0. Clear? If you want, you can solve the very same question like this. Total minus what is not required. Total minus what is not required. So what is not required? Anything less than 2 official members is not required. Okay. So less than 2 official members, it means 8C1 and 8C0. 8C1 and 8C0. This is not required. But we have to form a team of 5, and that is why 4C4. But 4C4, it means we have exhausted all the cases, and that is why this case is not possible. Otherwise, 8C0, there was no problem with 8C0. And sir, what is this total? 12C5. So 12C5 minus 8C minus 8C1 into 4C4. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Both these answers are absolutely same. Is it clear to each and every one of you? We have discussed 2 points, exactly and at least. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Why have I taken up to 5? Where? Here? Because that is what the team Have you guys logged in late? Because I've already told you that there are 8 official members and 4 non-official members, and we want to form a team of 5 members. That's why. I think it is clear to each and every one of you, right? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Great. Absolutely fine. Nice. Let's move on to the next one. Sir, after this, when you said this, we know that there are 8 official members and we also know that there are 4 non-official members. Sir, if we have been asked that, let us suppose if we ask that, at most, there are 2 non-official members. What is the meaning of this? When we have been told that we must have at most, that is maximum 2 non-official members, it means less than equals to 2 non-official members. Is it clear to each and every one of you? We'll be discussing these kind of nitty-gritties for the next 1.5 hours, for the next 90 minutes. Don't miss even one single thing what I'm saying. After this 90 minutes to 120 minutes duration, you're going to have a very beautiful notes and you'll understand most of the stuffs. Most of the stuff, because I cannot able to complete, it's not possible to complete the entire PNC probability in just 2 hours. But you learn whatever we'll discuss, the idea is not to complete, just to blatantly complete the topic. The idea is to make you understand every single bit of, you know, smallest of the things, so that you'll feel confident in these topics. So the less than or equals to 2 non-official members. Let's see. We've got 4 non-official members. Out of 4, we can select 1. Out of 4, we can select 0. That is what it means. At most 2, sir, won't be selecting 2. Yes, of course. 4C2. So at most 2 non-official members, it means 4C2, 4C1 and 4C0. But at the end of the day, we need to understand that we have to form a team of 5. So 8C3, 8C4 and 8C5. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? To all your friends who actually used to log in from on Createrix, because of some problem, I cannot able to go live on Createrix. So you can tell to your friends, or you can post it on Telegram, that they should come on RBR Search channel, right? Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Absolutely fine. Great. So this is what we have understood till now. Now listen to this very, very carefully. How many of you have played any sports like cricket, football, volleyball, badminton at any level, like regional level, cluster level, divisional level, state level, national level? Any of you who has played any game? How many of you played any game? Okay. Cricket, badminton, okay, right. I played cricket, right? I played nationals, and every Sunday I play cricket. Someday I'll show you my jersey as well. The tournament which we are playing is called Last Man Stands. It's a very nice tournament. That is the reason I don't take class on Sundays, because I play cricket. The leather ball cricket, not the tennis ball cricket, the leather ball cricket, proper cricket. So that is in the last match, I scored 51 and got 2 wickets as well. But I was not the man of the match. We lost the match. Unfortunately, we lost the match. But it makes you feel really good. When you play sports, it makes you feel very, very good. But whichever game, I know, like playing, I play most of the games. I love playing cricket, and other than that, football, I know a bit of football as well. I know a bit of, what do you say this? I don't know how to play hockey. But this shot put, javelin, discus throw, these are sports I know. But every time when volleyball as well. But every time when I play cricket, I prefer taking jersey number 4. Let's suppose there is a selection of Indian cricket team going on. There is Virat Kohli sahab mare. Mr. Virat Kohli usually prefers, what is the jersey number of Virat Kohli? I guess it's 9, right? So 99 or 9, something like that. I don't exactly remember. Mr. Dhoni has got jersey number 7. So let us suppose the selection of Indian cricket team is going on. And let us suppose Mr. Dhoni is also there. We said, sir, please you can come this side. You are by default selected and let's select the rest of the people. Sir, you are such a great player. You've always been such a great player. You have been a role model. So we said, sir, jersey number 7, sir, please you can come out here. You are already selected. Let's select the rest of the people. When we use the word a particular member, a particular official or non-official member must always be selected, must always be rejected, we mean that jersey number. Sir, what does that mean? Every time from now and onwards, whenever you see any question where it is written a particular, let me take both the cases actually. A particular official member is always selected. A particular official member is always rejected. Listen to this very, very carefully. Whenever you see this kind of question, always think in terms of jersey number. Particular official member must always be selected. We've got 8 official members and 4 non-official members. Listen to this very, very carefully. This class is all about these kind of nitty-gritties, these kind of small points. What exactly this question does not mean. This is absolutely incorrect. When you have been asked, a particular official member must always be selected. What does that not mean? It does not mean 8C1. When you say 8C1, it means any one person from 8 people. So what is the meaning of particular? Jersey number 7, there is only one person, jersey Dhoni sahab hamare. Jersey number 7, that is why it has to be 1C1. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? 1C1. So 1C1 is what you mean by when you say a particular, that is 1C1. A particular official member must always be selected, that is 1C1, not 8C1, right? So this is 1C1. But we need to understand, we want to form a team of 5 people. If one official member, one particular official member is already selected, we are left with 11 guys and 11C4. I know this value is equals to 1, but still I want you people to write it like this. If you write only 11C4, you will never actually, it might be possible your PNC is very good, but still I want you people to write this part. Although the value of this part is just 1, but still this will make you understand what is the meaning of a particular official member. A particular official member must always be selected, that is 1C1. And after that, once this guy is selected, what we are left with? 4. So 11C4, all in all, this is the answer. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine? Great. Absolutely perfect. Right? Nice. When we have been told that a particular official member is never selected. When we have been told that a particular official member is never selected. Let's not use any jersey number. Let us suppose jersey number X, whosoever that is. We said, sir, we are very sorry to say, but you are not selected this time. Once again, when we use the word a particular, this always means 1C1. So from today onwards, we'll think in terms of jersey, right? So what is that we are left with? There were 12 people. One person got rejected. So now we are left with 11. So the answer is 11C5. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear to all? Right. Sir, tell me one thing. Oh, what is this? Sir, tell me one thing. If this question would have been about a particular non-official member, a particular non-official member must always be selected, non-official member must always be rejected. Sir, what's the difference in the answer? Like, from where can we see the difference in answer? The answer will remain the same. A particular official member must always be selected, 1C1. Just the same way as we have written over here. 1C1. When we want to select jersey number 7, that's 1C1. We want to select jersey number 6, 1C1. We want to select jersey number 5, that is also 1C1. This is what the meaning of a particular is. And then whatever we are left with, 11C4. Is it clear, guys? It means that, sir, when you are saying that a particular jersey number must, a particular non-official member must not be selected, straight away we can write the very same answer, 11C5. We have discussed quite a lot of questions and under this. Is each one of you clear with every single thing whatever we have discussed? Guys, please try to log in on time, otherwise it's a very difficult. You know why? I'm a very firm believer of the fact that we believe we have time. We don't have time. We never have enough. We don't have infinite time. We always have a defined amount of time, right? So guys, please try to log in at the right time so that we can, you know, we should not waste time repeating the same thing again and again, right? I'm starting this right from the beginning. This is what we have discussed so far. Now listen to this. I said there are 8 official members and then there are 4 non-official members. We want to select 5. We want to select 5 members and form a team. What is that we can do? If there is no condition, we can write 12C5. This is for no condition. First of all, tell me, is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? We've got 8 official members and we've got 4 non-official members. And if we have been told that we have to select 4 members, we have to select 5 members. Without any condition, it has to be 12C5. Is it clear? Right. When nothing is mentioned, we have just been told that we have to select 3 official and 2 non-official members. What is that I told you? I said when nothing is mentioned, it is always exactly 3 official members and exactly 2 non-official members. Exactly 3 official members and exactly 2 non-official members must be selected. Exactly 3 official members and exactly 2 non-official members. And that is why 8C3 and 4C2. Is it clear, everybody? Once again, is it clear to each and every one of you? 8C3 and 4C2. I think this is absolutely fine, right? After this, we have been told that we need to select at least 2 official members. At least 2. It means at least 2. 2 or more than 2. So we can have 2 official members, 3 official members, 4 or 5 official members. Great. And rest of the people, because we need to form a team of 5. So they may come from non-official members. I think this is fine. Right? After this, we've discussed at most 2 non-official members. At most 2 non-official members. It means maximum 2 non-official members. So 2 or less than 2. So here we can have 2 non-official members or 1 or 0. That's fine. But at the end of the day, we need to form a team of 5 members. So rest of the people must come from official members. But another interesting part was a particular. Whenever it's written, a particular member must always be selected or a particular member must always be rejected, I told you guys, always consider the jersey number. What is that? Jersey number 7 must always be selected, 1C1. Jersey number 5 must always be selected, 1C1. Jersey number 1 must always be selected, 1C1. Jersey number, let's suppose 1000, must never be selected, 1C1. Jersey number 5000 must never be selected, 1C1. Is it clear to each and every one of you? The moment we have been told a particular, it always means 1C1. Is it clear, everybody? Is all these questions under this one roof, one umbrella question, absolutely clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine? Sir, indeed it is fine. And whatever we have discussed under this particular question is absolutely fine. Sir, but I have my reservations. Sir, I have my points. And what is that? Sir, this is a very nice question. But sir, you know what? Please don't mind. But you have started like 12C5, the no condition case. I think you started this question like from way too basic. I don't think this was required. probably. I don't know. So because I don't think like this part was required, we could have, you know, straight away taken then those questions. I have written something over here like 8 official, 4 non-official members without any condition, 12C5. Let's take this 12C5 and let's divide all the answers. Let's divide the first answer by 12C5. Let's divide the second answer by 12C5. Let's divide the third and fourth answer by 12C5. What will going to happen? The entire question transformed to probability. Is it clear, everybody? That is what the probability is. There is no existence of probability without permutation combination. Whenever you solve permutation combination, the very first case that you do without any condition, that is what we call sample space in probability. So this is the sample space. This is the total number of cases in probability. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? I think you have understood this, right? Great. Fine. Let's take another one. Even before moving further, let me take a very direct question. You won't believe in the year 2018, IIT Guwahati has given a very, very basic question. They said you need to form a committee of 3 people. Okay, we can. So, like how? There are total 9 people and you have to form a committee of 3 people. Answer after that, that's it. Out of 9 people, you have to form a committee of 3 people. I want you people to give me an answer within 30 seconds. I want you people to give me an answer. Even before setting the timer, probably you'll get the answer. I want you people to give me an answer in 30 seconds. Where is 30 seconds here? There are total 9 people and you want to form a committee. You want to form a committee of 3 people. That's it. This question was given in the year 2018 by IIT Guwahati. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Yeah, absolutely. So the answer is 9C3, that is 9, 8, 7, 1, 2, 3, 84. Is it clear to each and every one of you? I think this is absolutely clear. This was the question which was asked in the year 2018. Right? Absolutely perfect. Great. Let's take one more case. Not in your exam, but in some other exam, they have given a question. So what I'm trying to do, let me dilute the question and then I'll ask you that question. Before that, let us suppose this is flag of a country, right? It has got three horizontal layers like this. This is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. Okay. If we have been told that this country has decided to have a new flag, okay, and you are provided with 4 colors: yellow, green, blue, and red. Yellow, green, blue, and red. These are the 4 colors. So this country wants to have a flag such that these 3 horizontal plates will be there, and the 4 colors that has been provided to you are yellow, green, blue, and red. The only constraint you have, the two subsequent plates must not be of the same color, right? So the number of ways in which this can be done so that the adjacent strips must not be of the same color. This has been asked. It may sound slightly difficult, but it is very easy question. How come? Like this. Listen to this. This can be colored in four ways: yellow, green, blue, and red. Let us suppose this can be colored in four ways, right? Let us suppose what I've done, I have selected red color. So I have colored it in red. Let us suppose I have selected this color red. I want you people to see this. Whatever question we'll discuss in this class is very, very important to all the GATE 2021 aspirants. Okay. So when I started this question, I had four options: yellow, green, blue, and red. I have chosen red. Sir, why is that you've chosen red? You can choose any color. Out of these four, you can choose any color. In any which ways, you've got four options, right? Once again, when I move to the second part, second strip, we can have yellow, green, blue, but definitely not red, because that's the condition. The adjacent strips must not be of the same color. Okay, great. So here we've got three choices. Let us suppose if I select yellow. Let us suppose I select yellow over here. Okay. So this is how the flag is. This is how this particular strip of the flag looks like. Okay, that's great. Let's move on further. So when I move to the third strip, here I have once again yellow, blue, green, and red, four options. But as we have been told that the adjacent strips must not be of the same color, it means this cannot be yellow. So once again, we've got three options. Let us suppose I have selected, which color you want me to select? Let's suppose blue. So this is the new flag. So this is the new flag of the country. So this is the new flag of the country. So now the total number of ways, here we can clearly see that the total number of ways is 4 into 3 into 3. So the total number of ways would be 36. Is it clear to each and every one of you? So a new flag is to be designed. A new flag is to be designed with three vertical strips. Okay. And we were provided with four colors, which was yellow, green, blue, and red. The only condition that has been given to us was the two adjacent colors must not be same. So right at the beginning, I had four options. But if after this, because the two adjacent colors must not be same, so I cannot use red in the second case. So I had just three options. And similarly, right at the end, because I cannot use the same color, once again, I had these three options. So 4 into 3 into 3. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? No, IIT Guwahati made the paper in the year 2018. Is it fine? Yes. Now, you won't believe the question that was asked. In CAT, they asked this question. Let me tell you clearly. In CAT, they have asked this question. There is a new flag, and this question is not that difficult. This question can be really asked in your exam. In CAT, they have asked, there is a flag which has got six strips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. There are six strips. A new flag is to be designed and there are six strips. And the four colors that has been provided are yellow, green, blue, and red. The only condition is the two adjacent strips must not be of the same color. So now you have to find total number of ways. You have to find total number of ways in which this can be done. I am giving you guys 45 seconds. Go ahead. I am giving you guys 45 seconds and I want an answer. Make it fast, guys. Great, well done. Nice. Make it fast, guys, make it fast. Each one of you. Mm-mm-mm-mm. 655. Six strips are there, colors are only four. The first one can be colored in four different ways. The first one can be colored in four different ways. Whichever color you choose, that must not come at the second place. So 3, 3, 3, 3, and 3. This is the case. Is it fine, everybody? Yes. So this is 4 into 3 to the power of 5. That is 243 into 4 is 972. I think it is clear to each and every one of you. Is it fine, guys? Is it fine? Is it clear to each and every one of you? This question was asked in CAT, but I do believe these kind of questions, these kind of very straightforward questions you can expect in your exam. This question I have taken from CAT, and these kind of questions can come in your exam as well. Is it clear? Great. Let's move on. Tell me this one small thing. If the password of a laptop, of your laptop, let us suppose, if the password of your laptop is 01, and if I want to open it and I'm writing 10, will it open? If your password is 01, if even if your net, internet banking password is 01 or your laptop password is 01, if I'm using 10, will it open? No. Why? Because in case of password, arrangement matters. Just like in case of flag, arrangement matters. Okay. So if this is the case, in case of password, if arrangement matters, so if I ask you, like, form a two-letter password, right? So find a password, you have to form a password which has got three characters such that A, B, C, using these three alphabets A, B, C, and using the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I tell you, like, you have to form a password using two characters such that the password must contain one of the alphabet A, B, C and one of the four numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. How many distinct passwords are possible? You know what you will say? You will say A, B, C, 1, 2, 3, 3, C, 1. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, C, 1, okay. But at the same time, you can have arrangement as well. And therefore, 2 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? So this is basically 3 into 4 into 2, and that is 24. If I say that your password has got two characters such that the it must have one of the alphabet A, B and C, and it must have one of the number from 1, 2, 3, 4. How many distant passwords are possible? Distant passwords. So 3C1 into 4C1 into 2 factorial. Arrangement is also possible. If I ask you, if you have to form a password which has got three characters. Now you have got alphabets like A, B, C, D. You have got numbers like 0 to 5. And then special characters alpha, beta, gamma, theta. You have to solve this. So you have to form a three character pass. You have to form a three character password such that you have to form a three character password such that it must have what? One of the alphabet, like from A, out of A, B, C and D, it must have one alphabet. Other than that, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It must have one number and alpha, beta, gamma and theta. It must have one special character. How many total number of distant passwords are possible? How many total number of distant passwords possible? So what is the answer? Absolutely. That is 4C1, after that 6C1, after that 4C1, and after that 3 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, guys? Yes. So that is 4C1, 6C1, 4C1. Here the interesting part is, you know what is the interesting part? The interesting part is, here in this case, we had a 0. But that's fine. Even if you have a 0, 0 can come at the first place. In case of passwords, in case of telephone numbers, 0 can come at the first place. That's absolutely fine. We are not forming a 2-digit number or 3-digit number, so that the 0 cannot come at the first place. It is absolutely fine. The question, once again, it was the question which was asked in your exam. Once again, in the year 2018, IIT Guwahati made the paper and they have given this particular question. So the question which was asked in your exam was this. You have to form a password. You have to form an email password. This is what they said, which has got 3 characters. Okay. You have to tell me the answer, right? Either you will tell me the answer or I'll leave it as such. So this password has got 3 characters, number, alphabets from A to Z, capital letters, numbers from 0 to 9, and small letters A to Z. Total number of distant passwords possible. That is it. This question was asked in the year 2018 by IIT Guwahati. Go ahead, make it fast, guys. An email password must contain 3 characters. The password has to have, any of the alphabet from A to Z, and then from numbers from 0 to 9, and small character like A to Z. How many distant passwords are possible? 405, very good, shabash, well done. This is not my question, this is the question which came in your exam, right? So there are 26 alphabets, 10 numbers, and once again 26 alphabets. So out of this, we can select 26C1, this is 10C1, and this is 26C1. And the arrangement would be 3 factorial. Is it clear, everybody? So that is 40560. Someone has written the answer, which is absolutely correct. 40560. Once again, as I told you guys, this is not my question. This question was given to you by IIT Guwahati. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, guys? Is it fine? Absolutely. I think it is clear to each and every one of you, right? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Right. Yes. Great. Well done. Great, absolutely perfect. Not just in your exam, but even after this, whenever you come across any problem, any tough situation in your life, and at times you believe as if you should give up, take a small breather and tell yourself, it might be possible that the situation right now seems to be really tough. It might be possible that currently things are going haywire. But everything in this world, first point, is a perspective. Right now the situation is tough. Right now the situation is difficult for me with the current set of skills I possess. It also means that if I have better set of skills, or if I acquire more skills, I can grow beyond my problems. And that is the idea of human evolution. The main idea of human evolution is to become bigger than our problems. And the second point that you should tell to yourself, whatever I am surrounded and shrouded with different opinions, success, failures, different kind of emotions, tough situations in life, everything in this world has got a definite span of time. That is, death is inevitable. Not just for me, but for everything. Is duniya mein har cheez nashwar hai. everything in this world is destructible, and that is in Latin called memento mori. That is in Latin called memento mori. And if death is inevitable and so are problems, so why should I be ruffled by my problems? Instead of getting ruffled by my problems, I should think how to become bigger than my problems. There is one fantastic book written by Mr. Tony Robbins, and the name of the book is Awakening the Giant Within. I want people to read this even after the GATE exam, and that is every single time whenever we are at the middle of a problem or a negative situation or negative circumstances, we start to believe that I have got absolutely no power. How can like a small person like me, how can I face these kind of problematic situations? And we start to believe that, we start to play that victim card, that I probably am the victim of the circumstances, the situations. Tony Robbins said in this book that instead of doing this, every single time when you are at the middle of these kind of difficult situation, ask yourself, what is that I can do so that, what is that one thing that I should do right here, right now, so that I can improve my life? Not by 100%, not by 50%, not by 10%, just by 1%. What should that immediate action be so that I can improve my life just by 1%? And gradually and slowly you see you are coming out of the problem. It's a fantastic book. If possible, try to read this book, Awakening the Giant Within. And these are called, he said, these are called empowering questions. So he said there are two different kinds of questions, disempowering and empowering questions. Every time when you are at the middle of the tough situation, instead of asking a disempowering question, that is instead of playing the victim card, try to ask yourself empowering questions so that you can come out of that quagmire situation. Shall we proceed further, guys? Is it fine? Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Absolutely. Let's slightly level up the topic. What is the word? Let's take the word article. A-R-T-I-C-L-E. A-R-T-I-C-L-E. This is the word article. Great. Now listen to this. If nothing has been said to us, nothing, absolutely nothing, we want to find total number of arrangements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 alphabets, and the 7 alphabets, if there are total n distinct numbers or there are total n distinct alphabets, the total number of arrangement can be done in n factorial ways. Right? Similarly, if we have 7 distinct alphabets, we can have, for 7 distinct alphabets, we can have total 7 factorial arrangements. 7 factorial is 5040. Is it clear to each and every one of you? For n distinct items, if we want to arrange them in a linear way, the total number of arrangements would be n factorial. Similarly, right now we've got 7 alphabets. So 7 alphabets can be arranged linearly in 7 factorial ways. Is it clear to each and every one of you? All right. Let's take a few more cases in this. Let us suppose if we have been told that, let's take this, the first one, this is the second one. Let us suppose in this particular case, we have been told that, no, this alphabet A must come at the very first place. This alphabet A must come at the first place. Listen to this very, very carefully. This one question will help you understand these entire alphabet arrangement things, right? If we have been told that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If we have been told that A must come at the first place. Okay. We have been told that A must be come at the first place. A must come at the first place. if we have been told that A must come at the first place. In that case, total number of arrangements would be? Total number of arrangements for A, I want you people to write, I want you people to write it like this. 1 factorial. 1 alphabet, 1 place, 1 factorial. 6 alphabet, 6 places, 6 factorial. Sir, why have you written 1 factorial? Don't you know that the value of 1 factorial is 1? Of course I know. Of course. But by writing it like this, you can able to understand what this 1 factorial actually signifying. There is one alphabet A, and the arrangement of that alphabet A at the very same place would be 1 alphabet, 1 place, 1 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Yes, of course. So other than A, all the alphabets can be arranged. Thus, there are 6 factorial cases. Fine. Once again, as I told you, like this is the, these are the words. And if we have been told that no, here R must come at the first place and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. E must come at the last place. Okay. In this case, for this R, 1 factorial. 5 alphabet, 5 places, 5 factorial. And for this one, and I want you people to draw these arrows so that it will help you understand later on. Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear to all? Yes, absolutely. If we want, yes, absolutely. That is 5 factorial. R must come at the first place and E must come at the last place. So 1 factorial into 5 factorial into 1 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Great. Let's move on. Once again, in this case, article, if we have been told that, put up a single star on this question. 4th question. Put up a single star on this. All the vowels are together. Put up a single star on this. All the vowels are together. So how many vowels do I have? A, E, I. Whenever from now onwards, whenever you come across this word together, tie those alphabets. Like here in this case, A, E, I. Tie them together. Tie them together. What is that we are left with? R, T, C, L. Sir, what you said right now? I said whenever you see this word, not just the vowels, whatever you want, like these alphabets must come together, just tie them. When you tie them, it acts as one single alphabet. It acts as one single alphabet. And other than this, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here the total number of arrangements would be 5 factorial. And for this, it is not at all mandatory that A, E, I must come in the very same order. There can be 3 factorial arrangements of A, E and I. Is it clear to each and every one of you? So the answer must be 5 factorial into 3 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Atul's answer is absolutely correct. Well done. Atul and Mr. Jadav. Rutaj Jadav. Is it absolutely fine? Great. So, when you say that the vowels must be together, whenever you see this word together, whatever must be together, just tie them. So that it acts as one single alphabet. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So total number of arrangement would be 5 factorial for these things. But this, the arrangement for this would be 3 factorial. I want you people to answer in this particular case, in case of articles, A, R, T, I, C, L. If we have been asked, the total number of cases such that all the consonants must be together. Consonants must be together. All the consonants must be together. I want this answer from your side. If we have been told that all the consonants must be together, what should be the answer? Make it fast, guys. So these are the consonants R, T, C, L. So this is R, T, C, L. And then there is A, E, I. Yeah, what is the answer? Has anybody written any answer? Great. Absolutely. Absolutely perfect. So the answer is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. The answer must be 4 factorial into arrangement of this 4 factorial. 4 factorial into 4 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, guys? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Yes, well done. 4 factorial into 4 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? 4 factorial into 4 factorial. Right? I think you have understood every single point. Sir, once again, my very same doubt. What is that? Sir, the questions were really nice. But why have you started like from this basic? Take this 7 factorial and divide each answer. And the entire question will get converted into probability. This no condition case is basically sample space. So what is the, in case of the word article, what is the probability of getting this case? Such that the A must occupy the first place, that's it. Similarly, after this, the probability such that the R must come at the first place, E must come at the last place. The probability such that all the vowels are together. The probability such that all the consonants are together. Is it clear to each and every one of you? I think it is clear to each and every one of you, right? Instead of this, what will going to happen? Let me take a very basic example. If we have numbers like 1, 2, 3, if we have numbers like 1, 1, 2, if we have numbers like 1, 1, 1, right? Listen to this very, very carefully. If we have been told that find the total number of 3 digit numbers using the digits 1, 2, 3 without repetition, of course. So even if we want to solve this manually, we will say 123. Listen to this. 132, 213, 231, 312 and 321. These are the 6 cases. We can always write it like this. That's not a problem. And this is not that big a deal. But what we've discussed so far? N distinct numbers, total number of arrangement would be N factorial. So how many 3-digit numbers can be formed using the digits 1, 2, 3 exactly once? This would be 3 factorial. Total number of 3-digit numbers that can be formed using, listen to this very, very carefully. Total number of 3-digit numbers that can be formed using the digits 1, 1, 2, 3 factorial. Total number of 3-digit numbers that can be formed using the digits 1, 1, 1, 3 factorial. But what is the difference in these 3 cases? In the very first case, there is no repetition and that is why it is absolutely fine. On the contrary, here 2 digits actually got repeated and that is why divided by 2 factorial. Sir, why divided by 2 factorial? Because of these 2 cases. Here the 3 digits got repeated and therefore divided by 3 factorial. So here only 1 case is possible. And that is why only 3 cases are possible. And what these 3 cases, if you want to see those 3 cases, we can write those 3, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1 and 2, double 1. Is it fine, everybody? Is it fine to each and every one of you? Is it fine? So instead of, you know, directly, whenever you see these things, directly write 3 factorial, 3 factorial, 3 factorial. And then see the repetition. If 2 digits got repeated, divide by 2 factorial. If 3 digits got repeated, divide by 3 factorial and so on. I think it is absolutely clear to each and every one of you. Is it fine? Is it fine to each and every one of you? Right? Great. Let me ask you guys a question. The word is garden. The word is garden. My question to you guys, the very first one. Total number of arrangements such that no condition is there. Second, so that G must come at the first place. Third, G must come at the first place and R must come at the last place. Fourth question. All the vowels must be together. Fifth. All the consonants must be together. And that's it. Go ahead. Let's see who gets all five correct. To solve all these five questions, this will take barely 5 seconds, 5 to 10 seconds, 10, 30. Okay, let me give you 90 seconds. In 90 seconds, I want all the five questions. Go ahead, make it fast. 90 seconds I have given you. Make it fast, guys. Well done. And well done. If there is no condition, in that case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 factorial. If G must come at the first place, fix G at the first place, so this will be 1 factorial. Into 5 factorial. You can fix G at the first place and R at the last place. In that case, 1 factorial into 4 factorial into 1 factorial. That is actually 4 factorial. All the vowels must be together. How many vowels do we have? The vowels are A and E. That's it. So if you tie these two things together, this will look like this. A, E and G, R, D and N. So this would be 5 factorial into 2 factorial. And for the last one, the consonants must be together. Tie these things. So this would be 3 factorial, 1, 2, 3 and followed by 4 factorial. Is it clear to each and every one of you? How many of you have got all correct? Anybody who has got all correct? Anyone who has got 5 out of 5 correct? Where, how come 5? All the consonants must be together. Where 5? This. So this is 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 factorial and arrangement of these two things. Right? Well done. Shubhangi, Amardeep, Sarthak, Shweta, Sujit, Vimshi, Anshu, Gayatri, Pavan, Sonam, Rajat, Andrila, Subendu, Yash Patel, Gaurav, Prachi, Mini, Kirti, and many more guys. Garima, great to see. Well done. Absolutely fine. So this is absolutely fine, right? This is absolutely fine. Is it correct to each and is it fine to each and every one of you? Is it fine, guys? Right? You won't believe, in one of the competitive exam, they have given this question. It's a lawn tennis tournament. It's a lawn tennis court. Let us suppose it's a lawn tennis court. Fine. And a lawn tennis mixed double is going on. Mixed double is going on. It means there is a men and then there is a women. There is a men and women, right? That is what mixed double is. So what was given? This is what was given. Listen to this. This is what was given. There is a lawn tennis mixed double match going on. And then there are 7 married couples. Okay, fine. Let me break it into pieces. Let's take right from scratch. We've got 7 married couples. So we've got husband 1, husband 2, husband 3, husband 4, husband 5, 6 and 7. Fine. What is this question was asked in IFT actually. what I have done, I have diluted this particular question W2, W3, W4, W5, 6 and 7. So we have got 7 husband and 7 wife. So there are 7 husbands and 7 wives. Forget about everything. Let us suppose if we've got a mixed double. So in how many ways can we have this mixed double? So we need to understand that here in this case, we need 2 men. There is no other condition. And here we've got 7 of them. So from these 7 men, we can select any 2. Just to make you understand, let us suppose we have selected H1 and H5. Just to make you understand, let us suppose we have selected H1 and H5. So these 2 people got selected. Other than this, there is no condition as such. You can select whosoever you want. Now we have to select 2 women as well. So how many women do we have? Total number of 7 women. So we can select any of them. The only thing we want, we are looking for 2 women, 1 on either side. So once again, we've got 7 women. Out of 7, we can select 2. So let us suppose we've W2 and W6 got selected. Let us suppose W2 and W6 got selected. So is it the complete answer? No, right now this is not the complete answer. Sir, why is it so? Because the match is going on between H1, W2 in one team versus H5, W6. But this can also happen that we can have H1, W6 versus H5, W1. Sir, what does that mean? The arrangement is also possible. That is 2 factorial. Sir, in the similar way, these 2 husbands can also be arranged. Yaar, if you arrange the wife and you arrange the husband, so what you are doing? You are taking these 2 guys and you are placing it over there. So that is not an arrangement, right? You can arrange either of the 2. So right now we've got 7 married couple and we want to have a mixed doubles lawn tennis match, such that out of these 7 married couples, 7 husbands are there, 7 wives are there, such that we can have 2 husbands and 2 wives. So what we've done, in this case we had 7 husbands, out of 7 we've selected 2. Out of 7 wives, what we've done, we have selected 2 wives. And then the arrangement. Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? But this was not the question which was asked. Is it fine, everybody? 7C2, 7C2, 4 fed. No, that is what I said. It is, yes. If we want, you can use P2 or 2 factorial. Absolutely. Shweta and Prachi made the same mistake. If you write 2 factorial into 2 factorial, basically what you guys are doing, you are taking these 2 people and you are putting it over here. The quote actually got changed, but the team still remained the same. So that is why only 1 times 2 factorial. Is it fine, everybody? Is it fine? Let's take some condition in this. What kind of condition? Let us suppose here in this particular case, once again, this was the question which was actually asked. We want to play a mixed doubles. There are 7 married couples, 7 husbands and 7 wives. So out of 7 husbands, we have selected 2. And let us suppose H1 and H5 got selected. But now, right now, there is one more condition. What is that? This is the condition. There is a mixed double lawn tennis match going on. And if we want to have this mixed doubles match, there are 7 married couple and we have to form a team such that no husband wife play in the same set. And when you say no two husband wife play in the same set, it means not in the same team, neither in the same team nor in the opposite team. This is what it means. Set includes both teams, right? So when you say that no two husband wife play in the same set. You mean the same, the husband wife pair should not be there on this, in the same team or in the opposite? Sir, you mean to say that if we have selected H1, H5, these two ladies cannot be selected? Absolutely. These two ladies cannot be selected. And now we have got only 5 women, so 5C2. Let us suppose in this case we've selected W2 and what? W6. And then there's arrangement. This was the question which was actually asked. Is it fine, everybody? Have you understood the meaning of the word set? No two husband, right? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine? 7C2, 5C2. Yes, absolutely. 7C2, 5C2. 7C2, 5C2 into 2 factorial. Yes, absolutely correct. Now it is correct. I think we have understood this, right? Each and every one of you have understood every single piece of information. Is it correct, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Right. Now, furthermore, listen to this. Another point. A teacher in a classroom gave 2 true-false questions. He has given 2 true-false questions. Let's take a different concept. A teacher has given 2 true-false questions to the entire class. If no two students mark the same set of answers, right, and every student has marked the answer, then total number of students in the class. So if every student has given answer of both the questions and no two students have the same set of answers, let's do manually. So one student can say both the statements are true. One of them can say, no sir, first one is true and second is incorrect. The third, next one can say, no sir, only the first is correct but the second is incorrect. No sir, the first is incorrect but the second is correct. And no sir, both the statements are incorrect. A teacher has given 2 true false questions to the class. If all the students have marked the answer and no two students have marked the same set of answers, then total number of students in the class. This is what we can do manually. But at the very same time, listen to this very, very carefully. But at the very same time, this is what we can do. This is also what we can do. There are 2 students. So out of 2 students, 2C0. There are 2 questions. Out of 2 questions, there are students who said out of 2 questions, 0 is correct. 0 is incorrect. And then there are students who may say out of 2 questions, 1 is incorrect. And then there are students who said out of 2 questions, 2 are incorrect. That's fine. So out of these 2 questions, 0 is incorrect, 1 is incorrect, or this. So it means we can write it like this. And you know what? We can write it like this as well. Out of 2 questions, 0 is correct. Out of 2 questions, 1 is correct. Out of 2 questions, both are correct. This is called complementary combination, actually. Right? 2C2 is as good as 2C0. 2C1, 2C1, 2C0, 2C2. These are called complementary combinations. You know what? This entire thing can be written as, listen to this, NC0 plus NC1 plus NC2 up to NCN can be written as 2 to the power of N. This can be written as 2 to the power of N. Sir, what this 2 is? Wherever you have exactly 2 choices. Let us suppose the answer to a question is true or false. A student is present or absent. A person is married or unmarried. Exactly 2 choices. When you've got exactly 2 choices, then we can use this. And if you remember this correctly, this actually comes from binomial theorem. Right? X plus y to the power of n. Sir, you mean to say that in the previous question, instead of solving it like this, watch this very, very carefully and then I'll give you a question. Instead of solving it like this, we could have directly written 2 to the power of n, where n is the number of question. Of course, this is 2 square and 4. These are the four cases. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the four cases. Sir, you mean to say that, let's take an example of this. Let us suppose in your college you have to go through a semester exam. There are two sections A and B. Watch this very, very carefully and you'll understand every single thing. And there are three questions in section A and there are barely two questions in section B. If we have been asked, what is the total number of ways in which this question paper can be attempted? The total number of ways in which this question paper can be attempted. So ideally, how we should write? Ideally, 3C0, 3C1, 3C2 and 3C3. Sir, what does that mean? For section A, out of three questions, a person can attempt 0, or he can attempt 1 question, or he can attempt 2 questions, or he can attempt 3 questions. And at the very same time, for section B, the person can attempt 2C0, 2C1 and 2C2. Out of 2 questions, a person can attempt 0 or 1 or 2 questions. This is absolutely perfect. But instead of solving it like this, we can directly solve this as 2 to the power of n, that is 2 cube. And this is 2 square. This is for section A and this is for section. This entire thing can be written like this. And that is why this is 2 to the power of 5, that is 32. We'll take a few more cases of this, but is it clear to each and every one of you? Is this 2 to the power of 5 is clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Great. Listen to this very, very carefully. This is just the basic point and now we'll proceed further. Listen to this. So if a question paper is given, has been given to you, which has got 5 questions, but the question paper was divided into two sections A and B. Section A has got 3 questions, section B has got 2 questions. The total number of ways in which a student can attempt a paper. How many choices a person has? Exactly 2 choice. Like a person may attempt the paper, a person can attempt a question from A, or if he don't want to attempt the question, right? So he can attempt or he cannot attempt, right? This is what it means. So what we have written here, this entire thing can be written like this. And similarly, from whatever we've written, can be written like this. Sir, you mean to say that, let us suppose if the second question is, no, at least one question from question, say section A must be there, and there is no condition for section B. Now this is important. At least one question from B, forget about all these things. 2 cube. What is 2 cube? 2 cube is this. Whatever you can do with section A. But here we have been told that exact at least one question must be there. Minus 3C0. Sir, what is that? What you've done over here? 2 cube means 3C0 plus 3C1, 3C2 plus 3C3. When you are writing 2 cube, it means all these three things. Out of 3 questions, you can attempt 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. Is it clear to each and every one of you? But here we have been told that no, at least one question must be there, and that is why. Because at least one question must be there, that is why we have to subtract the 0 attempt. And because there is no condition for B, what we can do, we can directly write it like this. Now, this is a very nice point. 8 minus 1 is 7 and 7 into 4 is 28. Sir, let us suppose in this particular question, we know that there are 3 questions in section A, right? There are 3 questions in section A and there are 2 questions in section B. Let us suppose if the condition would have been what? At least 2 questions from A and at least 1 question from B. Forget about all these things. If you want at least 2 questions from A, first of all, how many questions are there? 3. That is ideally 2 cube minus. What is that you don't want? You want at least 2 questions. So what must not be there? 0 attempt must not be there. And 1 attempt must not be there. That's it. This entire thing is for section A. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Am I clear to each and every one of you? For section B, For section B, it is 2 square minus at least one attempt, that is 2C0. This is for section B. I think this is clear to each and every one of you, right? The moment you write 2 cube, it automatically means whatever you want, you can do with this section A. 2 cube means out of 3 questions, 0 attempt, 1 attempt, 2 attempt, 3 attempt, that's it. Now take this, like, what is that you are looking for? I want at least 2 attempts, so 0 attempt and 1 attempt shouldn't be rejected. Here in this case, you want at least 1 attempt, so 0 attempt must be rejected. I believe it is absolutely clear. Is it fine, everybody? Great. I want to be able to find this answer. Let us suppose there are 4 questions, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3. Let us suppose there are 4 questions in section A and there are 3 questions in section B. Total number of ways in which this paper can be attempted. Total number of ways in which this paper can be attempted such that what? First, no condition. I want people to give me answer of all these questions. Such that no condition is there. Second, at least one question from A and no condition for B. And no condition for B. And third, at least 2 questions for A and at least 1 question from B. Go ahead. I want all these 3 answers. Go ahead. Make it fast, guys. At least 2 questions from A, no condition, at least 1 question from A, no condition for B, at least 2 questions from A and 1 question from B. Go ahead, make it fast, guys. Nice. Great. So for the first case, there is no condition. So 2 to the power of 4 into 2 to the power of 3. That is 2 to the power of 7. So what is the answer? 128. Exactly one question. Sorry, at least one question from A. So what we should not consider? 2 to the power of 4 minus 4z0 into what? 2 to the power of 3. 16 minus 1 is 15 into what? 8 is 120. Here in this case, at least 2 questions from A. If you are saying at least 2 questions from A, it means 2 to the power of 4 minus 4c0 plus 4c1. And after that, one question from B, 2 to the power of 3, 3c0. This is 4 plus 1, 5. So this would be 11. And this would be 2, 8 minus 1, 7, 77. You can cross check the answer. So what is this? 16 and this 4 plus 1, 5. Yeah, 11 and this. Yeah, correct, I think. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Absolutely correct. Is it fine, guys? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine? Absolutely perfect, right? Right. How many of you have got all 3 answers correct? 128, 120 and 77. How many of you have got all 3 answers correct? The answer for the first one was 128. For the second one, it was 120. And for the third one, it was 77. How many of you have got all 3 answers correct? Great, well done. Great. Nice. Very good. So you have got all these answers correct. Instead of the questions, if we want, let us suppose if there are, like, there are people. For example, if there are 3 Indians and if there are, let us suppose, 2 Chinese people are there. And we want to select people from them. 3 from Indians and 2 Chinese guys are there. We want to form subgroups such that no condition is there, such that no condition is there. You can select as many number of people as you want. Okay, fine. So how many Indians are there? 3. So this is 3. Oh, sorry. 2 to the power of 3. How many Chinese are there? 2. 2 square. So total number of cases would be 2 to the power of 5. That is 32. But if we have been told that no, the subgroup you want to form, in that subgroup, you must have at least one Indian. At least one Indian. And for the Chinese, there is absolutely no condition. If this is the case, we can write it like this. This 3C0 into 2 square. This 2 cube is 8. 8 minus 1 is 7. And 7 into 4, this is 28. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Absolutely correct. Is it fine? 28, absolutely. In the year 2017, IIT Roorkee had given this question. What was the question? 2017, IIT Roorkee had given this question. What exactly was the question? The question was, there are 3 Indians. There are 3 Indians. And then there are 3 Chinese. There are 3 Indians and there are 3 Chinese guys. There are 3 Chinese. You want to form a subgroup such that the only condition was it must have at least one Indian and there is no condition with the Chinese. What is the answer? Go ahead, take 30 seconds and mark the answer. The only condition is you must have at least one Indian and there is no condition with the Chinese. You can have as many Chinese as you want. What do you think? What is the answer? Great, well done. This question was asked in the year 2017. In case of Indians, the total answer would be 2 cube minus 3C0 into 2 to the power of 3. So this is 7 into 8 and this is 56. You got the answer? Well done. 56, absolutely correct. Nice. Let's take one more point actually. Shall we take one more point? I think we should take. Is everybody fine if we take one more point? Just one more. Let us suppose 1, 2. Let's take a chessboard, although it's not that beautiful, but it's fine. Just for the understanding purpose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And listen to this very, very carefully. So in a chessboard, there are black, white, right? I'm just making it white so that you can understand. I'm not doing it very properly. The idea is not to fill these blanks, just to make you understand that it somewhat looks like a chessboard. That's it, right? This does not need to be very beautiful, but I just want you people to understand that this is a chessboard. That's it. So this is a chessboard. So here we have a chessboard. So this is a chessboard. I want you people to draw this in your notebooks. So we have a chessboard like this. There are 3 things which can come. There are 3 questions which can come on chessboard. What these three questions are? What these 3 questions are? You can write. Right. Now listen to this. Based on chessboard, you will find questions not just in your written paper, but also at the time of interview as well. Do remember this. So I want you people to write a note. And the subheading of the note is chessboard. Listen to this very, very carefully. If we have been asked total number of squares in a chessboard, don't say 64. 64 is fine, but it's more than that actually. when we say total number of squares in a chessboard, you know, what is the meaning of this? When you say 64, 64 is this, 1 cross 1 square. This 1 cross 1 square is 64. How come this 64? Because this is 1. And then there is another 1, 2. Listen to this very, very carefully. Then there is 3. Then there is 4. 5. Okay, 6, 7, and then the last one, 8. Just to make you understand, I have taken all these colors. Right, this is 8. So when you say it's a chessboard, and when you say total number of squares in a chessboard, it's not just 64, it's more than that. 64 is basically 8, it behaves like an 8 cross 8 matrix. That's fine, listen to this. But you know, one more kind of square can come. We can have a 2 cross 2 square as well. Okay. This is what we mean when we say 2 cross 2 square. This is the first one. Okay. Then there is the second one. Okay. Then there is the third one. Then after this, there is fourth one. Can you able to understand? Right? Then there is fourth one. Just to make you understand, I'm doing this. Then there is then there is the fifth one. Okay. Then there is the sixth one. And finally the last one. The seventh one. Yeah, that's pretty obvious. Because we are taking 2 cross 2 squares, so one line will decrease. So in case of 1 cross 1, there is one. In case of 1 cross 1 square, there are 64 squares. There are 64 squares. Similarly, when you take 2 cross 2 squares, we're going to have this. 1 square. 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square plus 5 square plus 6 square, plus 7 square, plus 8 square. What is this 8 square? When you have been asked total number of squares in a chessboard, this 8 square, that is 64, this is basically that 1 cross 1 square I was talking about. This 7 square, 49, is basically that 2 cross 2 square. This is that 3 cross 3 square, 4 cross 4 square, 5 cross 5 square, 6 cross 6 square, 7 cross 7, and finally this is the 8 cross 8, that is this entire square. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? So total number of squares, total number of squares won't be 784, it would be 204. Yes, so total number of squares would be, what is the total number of squares? Sum of square of n natural numbers, right? So that is 204. Now just think of this. If anywhere in your exam, if it has been asked that, what is the probability in a chessboard, what is the probability of getting a 7 cross 7 square? So 7 cross 7 square, 4 square, 2 square, sorry, 2 square is 4, 4 divided by 204. The probability of getting a 2 cross 2 square, 49 divided by 204. The probability of getting a 3 cross 3 square, 36 upon 204. Probability of getting 8 cross 8 square, 1 divided by 204. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to all? So total number of squares is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square up to 8 square. And thus the total number of square pans out to be 204. Similarly, if we are asked total number of rectangles in a chessboard, if we are asked total number of rectangles in a chessboard, total number of rectangles in a chessboard, what is the meaning of that? Let me clear this. Total number of rectangles in a chessboard, listen to this very, very carefully. If you are concerned about the total number of rectangles in a chessboard, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In a chessboard, there are 9 vertical lines. Obviously, they're 90 degree, right? Similarly, there are 9 horizontal lines as well. Similarly, there are 9 horizontal lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So if it has been asked like find the total number of rectangles in a chessboard, straight away you can say horizontal C2 into vertical C2. This is how an ideal rectangle looks like. This is how an ideal rectangle looks like. Horizontal C2, 9 C2, vertical C2, 9 C2. That is 1296. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? So total number of squares in a chessboard, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to 8 square. And thus you can have 204 squares. Total number of rectangles in a chessboard. Horizontal C2 into vertical C2. Even if we want to find the total number of parallelograms in a chessboard, do remember a parallelogram looks like this. So what does that mean? This 90 degree is not a mandatory condition for a parallelogram. This 90 degree is a must for a rectangle, but this 90 degree is not a must for a parallelogram. Is it fine, everybody? Sir, what does that mean? It means this. If we have been told that there are m parallel lines, if we have been told that there are m parallel lines and there are n parallel lines, if these lines cut each other, then total number of parallelograms, we can say MC2 and into NC2. This is the total number of parallelograms. But here in this case, if we have been asked total number of rectangles, but here if we have been asked like total number of rectangles cannot be determined because we are not aware of the fact whether they are 90 degree or not. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? Is it fine to each and every one of you? Right? So total number of squares in a chessboard, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to 8 square. Total number of rectangles in a chessboard, 9C2 into 9C2. This particular question, like total number of rectangles, not in a chessboard, but in a grid, has already been asked in your exam. Like this. For example, if I give you a grid, when you use the word a grid, this automatically means they are 90 degree, right? 1, 2, 3. It's a 90 degree line. It's a grid, 90 degree. So here, if someone wants to find total number of rectangles, what we know, horizontal C2 into vertical C2. How many horizontal lines do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That is 5C2. How many vertical lines do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is 6C2. And that is why the answer is 150. So total number of rectangles can be 150. Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Great. 5C2 into 6C2. Shall I give you a question? You need to find total number of rectangles. I have given you a grid. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 2, 3, 4. Check this and you have to tell me total number of rectangles in a chessboard. A similar question was given by IIT. You have to tell me total number of rectangles. Consider that these are 90 degree. Go ahead, make it fast, guys. Consider that these are 90 degree. What is the answer? Absolutely. So horizontal lines 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 4C2. And what about the vertical lines? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is 6C2. Right? What is 4C2? 4C2 is basically 6. And this is 15. 15 into 6 is 9090. Absolutely. When I say vertical, I mean these lines. When I said vertical, these lines. Is it clear to each and every one of you? And similarly, in case of parallelogram, if I say there are 4 parallel lines, this is not at all must that they are 90 degree. Like when they cut, they are 90 degree. And then there are 5 parallel lines. What do you think? Total number of parallelograms would be? So let 10 into 5C2 into 4C2. This is 10 and this is 6. The answer would be 60. Is it clear, everybody? Is it fine to each and every one of you? In today's class, I have discussed many questions which came in your exam. This kind of question you can expect. They have already asked total number of rectangles and total number of parallelograms. Is it clear, everybody? Is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it fine? Yes, great. If I tell you that there are 1, 2, 3, 10 parallel lines, and here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 parallel lines. Then total number of rectangles, there are 10 parallel lines and then there are 5 parallel lines. The total number of rectangles would be, go ahead, mark the answer. Total number of parallelograms would be, there are 10 parallel lines and there are 5 parallel lines. The total number of parallelograms would be, absolutely, this would be 10C2 into 5C2. And the answer would be 450. I think it is absolutely fine. Yes. So this was the today's session. Has everybody understood whatever we have discussed in today's class? Great. I have taken many questions from your, the questions which have already been asked in your exam. So I have taken many questions which are very, very important to you. Whatever we have discussed, is it clear to each and every one of you? Is it clear? Great, well done. So that is it for the day. Don't forget, right now it is almost 8 o'clock. Go and have a dinner. And don't forget, we're going to have a class at 10. 10 late evening, we're going to have a class. We're going to have a verbal class. Right? Is it fine, everybody? Great. So I'll see you guys at 10 late evening. Meanwhile, go and have your dinner. See you at 10. Bye-bye, everybody. Take care. Jai Hind.